Living in Hawaii, many of us grew up on or around the beach and maybe accidentally swallowed a little bit of water here and there. Well, that very thing nearly cost a Florida toddler her life. 4-year-old Ileana accidentally inhaled swimming pool water. She seemed fine, but then a few days later, she began running a fever. Her mom had just learned about what's called dry drowning or secondary drowning. Jen Beniza asked the experts what we all need to know to protect our families. Jen?
Dash drowning is the leading cause of death for children ages 1 to 4. Experts say dry and secondary drowning are rare. With summer approaching, more families will be heading to the beach and the pool. I reached out to a local doctor to find out more. Dr. Travis Hong is a pediatric emergency physician at Kapi'olani Medical Center.
The secondary drowning phenomenon refers to when the patient's pulled out of the water. They look to be okay, they go home, and then something happens, and at that point they drown while they're home, hence the term dry drowning.
He tells me the problem occurs when water enters the child's lungs.
And then that causes an inflammatory response, which can then cause symptoms of drowning.
In case their child has swallowed a whole bunch of water and they've come from the beach or the pool,
yeah. What
should they be looking for?
That's a great question. You just want to look out for things such as respiratory distress. So their child breathing quickly, struggling to breathe, coughing uncontrollably, obvious things like turning blue in their face. Those are the warning signs.
In those cases, Dr. Hong says go immediately to the ER. He says these symptoms happen within minutes, not days later.
There have been some studies looking at dry drowning in pediatrics in particular, and recent autopsy reports and historical information, it turns out that actually it doesn't exist as a true medical phenomenon. Typically what instead is happening is, one, either water does enter the lungs during the actual submersion event, and then that causes an inflammatory response, which can then cause symptoms of drowning.
Dr. Hong also wants to remind parents to always keep an eye on their children. He says the majority of accidents happen when children are unsupervised. Dash, Marissa.